Hello students, welcome to the statistics class. So in today's session we shall begin with our first chapter, that is introduction to statistics. So let us look at some origin and development part of the statistics. So when man started counting, comparing and keeping records in one or the other way, the subject statistics seems to have originated. The word statistics seems to be derived from the Latin word status, or the Italian word statista, or the German word statistic, or the French word statistique, each of which means a political state. So in our real life we all have competitive situations where we start comparing one thing with another, or we start comparing ourselves with others. Okay, suppose you are a manufacturer, so you are manufacturing a particular item. Suppose say you are manufacturing a scooter. So when there is no competition against you, then there will be no comparison. When there is no comparison, then there will be no statistics. This is what the first paragraph means. Okay, so manufacturing a scooter, so there is no competitor for a while against you. Now comes into a picture another person who is competing with you. He is bringing something special features in his scooter, so now starts the competition. So now he has a product which is better than you. So now you start to think, what should I do in order to make sure of being ahead in the game always. So this is when you start comparing his product and your product. So you try to understand what makes his product better than yours, or what should you do, or what changes you should make in order to make your product better than his product. So this is when a competitive situation starts, the application of statistics begins. Okay, so statistics has been derived from different languages. In Latin it means status, in Italian it means statista, in German it is statistic, in the French it is statistique, all of which means a political state. So in olden days kings used to collect records. Kings used to collect records regarding their subjects. Here the subjects means the people living in his kingdom. So there will be different kinds of people living in his kingdom, people belonging to different stratas or different groups. For example, there will be traders, there will be agriculturists, there will be soldiers who will be working for him, etc., etc. So all of them, he has to look after them, their livelihoods, everything. So he has to also look out after his kingdom, his administration. So he needs money. So for money, the king collects taxes. Now you cannot collect the same amount of tax from each and every person. So some people are taxable, some people can't be taxed because they don't have such an income. So the king uses his administrative people to collect the data in order to understand the incomes of different people of his kingdom. So on the basis of that, they will create, design and implement certain tax reforms. So this is how in olden days kings used to apply statistics, knowingly or unknowingly, in order to run their administration. So that is why the meaning is political state. So in initial days it was restricted to political affairs of a kingdom. Okay, so Sir Ronald A. Fisher is considered as father of statistics. So Sir Ronald A. Fisher he is considered as the father of statistics for his enormous contributions to the field of statistics. Basically he belongs to the life sciences community, but he applied statistics and designed and derived some wonderful theories which we are using even now. So we shall look at them in the later part of our curriculum. And Prasanth Chandra Mahalanobis is called the father of Indian statistics. So June 29th is the date when we celebrate as Indian Statistics Day. It is the birthday of Prasanth Chandra Mahalanobis, or known as PC Mahalanobis. He is called as the father of Indian statistics. He is the founder of Indian Statistical Institute, which is in Kolkata and which has spread out its branches in Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad. So these were some early forefathers of statistics globally and locally, that is in India. Okay. So let us look at the definitions of statistics. So statistics here, let us define it as a numerical statements. So statistics as numbers or numerical statements. Okay. So Professor Horace Sechrist defined statistics as, statistics may be defined as aggregate of facts affected to a marked extent by multiplicity of causes, numerically expressed, enumerated, estimated according to a reasonable standards of accuracy, collected in a systematic manner for a predetermined purpose and placed in relation to each other. Looks like a very big definition here. Let us break it down point by point. Okay, the first point here is, statistics may be defined as aggregate of facts. So we need to understand this line here, aggregate of facts. So statistics is something that you cannot use only one point or one fact. For example, if I want to analyze the performance, the academic performance of a classroom, so I cannot just select randomly any one student, analyze his marks and say that the class is either good or bad. So in a classroom there will be students of different types. Some of them will be high scoring, some of them will be medium scoring, some of them will be mediocre scoring. A section of students will be failing in the class. So I cannot just select any one of the student and say this class is a failure class or this class is a brilliant class or etc. etc. So I need a bunch of facts. I need students from all the groups. So statistics is an aggregate of facts. So statistics is a group of facts, not a single fact, affected to a marked extent by multiplicity of causes. So now once I select the students, I need to understand the way the students are. So some of them will be high scoring, some of them will be medium scoring, some of them will be mediocre scoring, and some of them will be failures. So what factors are there which are affecting them to score like that? So that is the second point. Third one is numerically expressed. So in statistics, numbers are very important. So whatever phenomena is there in front of you, you will always believe only when you have a number there. For example, you hear about the online shopping portals where they say discounts. So there, if they say we are giving discounts, you won't believe them. If they say we are giving 40% discount, 50% discount, 30% discount, so there they are giving you a number, 30%, 40%. So that makes you believe them, because we always believe in when something is expressed in numbers. For example, suppose somebody asks you what is your weight, so you will express it in terms of numbers only. You won't say that you are too fat or too thin or whatever it is. You always say, I am, say, 70 kg or 60 kg or 55 kg, whatever it is. So you always express phenomena in numbers. So in statistics are numerically expressed. Okay. Next, enumerated or estimated according to a reasonable standard of accuracy.